Hello, hello, today I'm going to show you an awesome unboxing video by me, for you. Today let me introduce you the Autel MaxiLink ML329 code reader. With one click, I am Redinsky and Auto VIN function. It is a car scanner, advanced version of the AL319. You have a wide vehicle application. That diagnostic tool will bring you convenience in testing various car models after 1996, including Ford, Honda, Chevrolet, Jeep, Toyota, Dodge, Nissan, VW, etc. And you can easily get details of the given car with your advanced Auto VIN function. Quick read and clear codes. With that car scanner, you can retrieve generic PO, P2, P3 and UO, manufacturer-specific P1, P3 and U1 codes, pending codes in seconds, and when you finish the repair, you are capable of clearing the diagnostic trouble codes and turning the MIL off. Accurate info retrieval. This ML329 has commonly used IM redeem status to determine whether the emission related system are alright, and the freeze frame data to identify specific conditions on the car when the fault occurs. To save your time and money, and it's a plug and play feature, there's no built-in battery with the code reader, so you don't need to worry that the battery run out. After being plugged in the OBD2 port, it will run a diagnostic and show vehicle-specific condition on the back, light and colorful screen. And you have lifetime free online update with it. This is awesome. Autel is one of the world's leading manufacturers and suppliers of professional diagnostic tools, equipment and accessories in automotive aftermarket. Since that foundation, they have been committed to creating maximum long-term value to customers worldwide by providing quality assured, easy to use and cost-effective and innovative products. And the Autel MaxiLink ML329 with its patented one-click IM readiness key enables user like me to check state emissions monitor status and verify repairs, read and erase codes on domestic, Asian and European vehicles, 1996 and newer, and it's so easy to use. You have one button for IM, one button to get scroll and want to enter and exit the menu. And if you like, you can print your solutions. Oh, this is easy too. You can have a freeze time or a freeze setup in this. You can have the unique one-click IM readiness option. You can use it easy to use Auto VIN technology and lifetime free update servers. Oh, this sounds great. And now we are going to a car to have a look how it works. And it is really easy to use. And it will save you so much money because one setup in a garage will cost you up to $50 each reading. And this is really expensive, but this little device is cheap and reliable. I have in each car of my cars one OBD2 scanner all day long. So there it is. Let's go to a car and have a setup with it. Let's go. Okay. Let's have a look how we can connect and use this OBD2 scanner, MaxiLink ML329. Open the driver's side of your car. In this case, it's an Audi.
In the case of the Audi A3 and A1, for example, Sportback, the OBD2 hub is detected underneath here. You can go to the pedals here. You know, the pedal, the clutch, the brake, and acceleration. Here you have the device. Here's the OBD2 wire and the OBD2 plug. And underneath here, there it is. This is your OBD2 spot. Here you can dock this cable. So you have to rotate it on the right direction and push it into position. And here we are. We can get now into the system. But now first we have to have a seat here. Let's have a seat inside the car and close the door. So here we are. We are sitting in the driver's seat. And the cable is enough to come to you up to your place where you have the seat. So next thing we are going to do is turn the ignition on. So let's rest it here. Turn ignition on. You do not have to turn on the vehicle itself. The engine does not have to start now. First step is now we are heading into the machine. Here we can see scroll, scroll, scroll. And here we can see about setup, ready, test, OBD2, eOBD. Okay, let's have a look about. This is a MaxiLink ML329 in the version 1.13. Okay, there is some information, serial number, password, etc. Good. Let's go back, exit. Now, scroll, for example, to setup. You can see language, configure monitors, unit of measure, key, beep setup, status beep setup, update mode, set data log, upload, data log mode, previous menu. You can have a setup in this device, of course. So let's go to OBD2 eOBD check. Enter into the system, waiting for vehicle to respond. Can SCD fast communicating, and here you can see it's a manufacturer Audi reading system status. Oh yeah, here the LED is on. That means no codes were detected now. This is nice. But if you have a code, I think here are the LEDs in red or yellow will be on, and you can read the code again. So read codes, reading codes. Please wait. No codes are stored in the model. Press any key to continue. That means if you have some failure code, this DTC will you will see in the screen, and then there is information under it, and you can have this is a pass of the threat to your problem inside your car, like an engine problem or otherwise. So okay. If you have a code, you can go and erase codes. Here, erase codes. Then you have to enter erase trouble codes. Are you sure? Yes, of course. Now enter and the codes will be DTCs and freeze data will be lost. Do you wish to continue? Yes. And now the codes which are in the system will be erased immediately. Here we are. Erase codes, company set, perform read codes, function to verify. Okay. So now, live data. View freeze frame. I am readiness. Vehicle information. Let's get into this. Turn key on with the engine off. Vehicle ID number. Manufacturer's Audi. Year is 2014. Here's the vehicle identification number. Exit. Calibration ID, calculated verified number, in use perform track, ECU name, and everything others is here. You can read, you can scroll, and previous menu, set data log, previous menu. Okay, here's some information about the diagnostics. Now, let's get out of it. Here we are back in the scene, on the main scene. How we checked the inside, the OBD2 functions, this is cleared. How to erase the codes, this is cleared. Now let's get to another option, ready test. Okay, let's have a look what this is. So, can STD fast, waiting for Rico to respond. Can STD fast, this is the communication. I am Rian, please wait. Now you can see what is here. You have no engine information light off. This is off. If you have it on, it will be in the situation there. Then DTC, no codes, panning codes, no measurements, CAT, nothing here, O2. That is because our engine is still off. Okay, so here you can see everything on one screen, the IM Redinus. So exit. Now let's have a look to the live data. For this, we're going to start the engine. Okay, let's go. Start the engine. So engine is on. Okay, let's go. Here you can see engine is still running. Now we are going back to the machine and scroll, 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 scroll. Now let's have our OBD. Let's get back into the system. Can STD fast. Engine is still running, as you can see. Now you can see we are back in business here. So, monitors, okay, freeze frame, live data. Let's go to live data. Please have a look for the live data. Reading the live data into this device here. Oops. And then we have some information about now here. DTC, no failure codes. Fuel system is clear. Here's the load pressure, the temperature, and here we can scroll how fast we're going to drive, rounds per minute, how much key PA long, feet in percent. Now, okay, let's have a look. Here you can see it's live. I will get a little bit acceleration, and there it is. You can have a look what's now. Yeah, no? The data will be in live. This is immediately set up here. So let's have a look what's now. Temperature, O2 clears, thrift, how long in seconds the engine will run. Oh, everything, warm ups, clear distance. La la la, so many information. Lambda, oh, lambda is good. Let's give a bit, little bit acceleration. Here you see lambda 1, okay, it's a good lambda value. So load pressure, so many information. This is awesome. Okay, now we're back here. And what is, if I'm pushing enter, live data, read codes, view freeze frame, I am readings. So let's go here. What is with the IAM button? You can go every time in the IAM button. Here you can see. Good job. Okay. This is the IAM button. You can get into it by using the menu, of course, or you use this. This is the one screen for every things what is going on here. So, okay. Exit. Previous menu. Exit. Yeah, so that it is. You can see what you can see or what is in your car right now. You have a fast and easy communication with your car, with your OBD2, and you can read and erase the failure codes. This is important. You have a good in color display. I like it, and it's easy to use, really easy to use. If you finish the work, so for example, we can make a setup again. This is fast, really fast responding, and it is handheld weight. It is easy to connect, as you can see, and it's all on one screen. Nice, really nice. So that is good. I like it really much. This should be in every car out there. So let's go to add setup. Let's have a change of the language. France, German or English. Let's change to English. To German, sorry about this. So, nice. I like it really much. It's a good tiny device. And now we are back in the main menu. Then you can unplug the device.
Pulling there. Good job.
And then the machine is disconnected. Awesome. So that it is how to use your Maxilink ML329, and this will help you a lot in the failure diagnostic at your car. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe me and give me a positive feedback, and I hope to see you again on my channel. Soon.